What is on the docket today?
It's a full itinerary, Kay, for Kirk Cousins throughout this day. He's staying in downtown Minneapolis. So my understanding is they're going to take him this morning to see U.S. Bank Stadium, where he's going to be playing his home games for the next several years. Then he will come to the facility. He'll see all the amenities, the fireplaces in the locker room, the cryo chamber. But then he'll also sit down with the coaches and actually talk football. Offensive coordinator John DeFilippo and quarterbacks coach Kevin Stefanski were at that dinner last night. Today, though, they actually get to get him in a room and show him, this is what we think the offense is going to be like with you as the centerpiece. There is still some work that they've got to do on the contract. The parameters have been in place since Tuesday, though. They got to work on some things in terms of the structure of the guarantees. A lot of confidence in speaking to people on both sides that this thing will get done today.
All right, Tom, stick with me for a second. Hypothetically speaking, if Kirk Cousins were to leave Minnesota without signing a deal, where did the two sides go from there?
Nate, the lack of a good answer to that question probably tells you everything you need to know about how likely that is to actually take place. As Rick Spielman told reporters when he was leaving the restaurant last night, it would be hard to not get it done now. The quarterback market moved quickly, starting with Case Keenum signing Monday night with the Denver Broncos. Sam Bradford goes to Arizona. Teddy Bridgewater and Josh McCown end up with the Jets. Yesterday, A.J. McCarron signs on with the Buffalo Bills. That's not to say that if things did fall apart that people would not be lining up and the Kirk Cousins would not have options, but everybody has kind of moved forward. Teams have paid money. And for the Vikings, if you're looking out there at your other options, there is not a whole lot there. They've taken precautions, though. The Vikings have rolled out the red carpet, and that's a big deal to Kirk Cousins. One thing that I always heard about Cousins in Washington was he never felt like he was treated as the franchise quarterback, never treated as the Redskins treated Robert Griffin III when he was the guy in Washington. The Vikings couldn't talk to Cousins until the league year began at 4 o'clock yesterday. They couldn't reach out to him directly to set up the visit, but his agent had told them this is going to be the first visit, and the Vikings knew he was in Atlanta. So what did they do? They called Cousins right at 4 o'clock, said, we got a car for you in 15 minutes. Wow. It's taking you to a private jet. We're going to get you here, wine you, dine you, and make this thing happen.
That's all I wanted. Ask the boys. I said, just wine and dine Kirk Cousins. He's out in the promise ring back-to-back years. Put a ring on it. Enjoy it. And I'm glad he's being treated that way because he's not the only quarterback coming to town. Our very own NFL Network insider Ian Rappaport reporting that the Vikings are closing in on a deal to get Trevor Siemian from the Broncos. So I ask you, Tom, how does that impact the entire Cousins negotiation?
The only real impact of that would be Rick Spielman said that Cousins agent Mike McCartney will be in the building to finalize the contract. Maybe he'll give a high five on his way out the door to Trevor Siemian because he happens to represent both of these quarterbacks. Siemian was the logical next step as the Vikings were putting together their plan because, again, their three quarterbacks on the roster last year, veterans, have all signed elsewhere. This is a championship-level team. You don't want your season to completely fall apart if something does happen to Kirk Cousins. And then Trevor Siemian, you get a guy who's 26 years old. He's got 24 NFL starts, do less than $2 million in salary this season. There is tremendous value there, potentially for a team that wants to make sure, no matter what happens, it can stay on a Super Bowl course.
Great stuff from Tom Pelissero there.